These protests continue after hundreds gathered outside the Indiana State House and throughout downtown Indy over the weekend.
We're about love. We don't want to fight. We just want peace. Can we fix this now, please?
For the first time, one of the organizers of that anti-Trump rally downtown this weekend is talking to RTV6 about the chaos and violence that erupted after it ended. Call 6 Investigates' Per Subel is working for you today, digging into the information about those protesters since they were arrested. Per, what are you learning?
Good evening, Melissa. Now, those 7 that were arrested, police are calling them instigators. They were all arrested in the block there behind me. And today, rally organizers saying that group ruined what was supposed to be a peaceful rally.
Watch out, rock! It's all bottles and rock! It's all bottles and rock!
Coming everything at us. And work hard.
For nearly 3 hours before that point, the rally was peaceful.
We sat there for hours just having a peaceful, people were upset and yelling, and when it got any rambunctious because of the crowd, we calmed it right back down and it was fine.
Kim Saylor is one of the rally's 14 organizers, and she's been organizing rallies here in Indiana since RFRA. She says everything was going well Saturday night. Nearly 500 people showed up to the rally, but all of a sudden it changed.
When we came around the circle, another group of protesters that were not with us at the rally joined in from Meridian.
Police say threats were being made against them, and then rocks and bottles started flying. That's when things got out of control. Police eventually calmed things down and arrested these 7 people, calling them the instigators.
Muddied the really good message because my community healed and they're still trying to heal, and now I've created a safe place for them to come where we can close out agitators because we're tired of being attacked.
Now, the rally organizers say they are going to regroup and plan to have more protests here near the State House, but will do everything in their power to make sure nothing like that ever happens again. Now, police originally said on Saturday night that 3 of the protesters that were arrested were from out of state. We did some digging today to look into their records and their backgrounds, and it appears that they're all from Indiana. We're getting some clarification right now from police. We'll bring you an update just as soon as we have it. For now, live from the State House, I'm Call 6 Investigates, Paris Lubel.
Paris, thank you. RTV6.